When people ask me about the old gold mine,
the lost city site and the church. Hopefully with excavation we'll prove that it's pre-Anglo and Spanish colonial. You'll notice one tree, foot and a half thick, has grown in the entranceway to the church and the building.
I noticed that.
Dimensions of the building are estimated 15 by 45, similar to the little mission seen at LW's place, to which 10 years of excavation have been done down there. Okay, get a shot of me. I want you to see this. I'm just picking this up off the ground right here. This, my friends, is the reason that the people came here in the very beginning. Precious metals. Very beautiful.
That it is.
Nothing has been moved, nothing has been disturbed. Over the years, we've never moved anything or disturbed it. We do not plan to until there's qualified archaeologists. The location will be kept a secret. Very tightly guarded secret. The Forest Service 2 years ago on May the 12th was here. The site was recorded.
Through the entrance with a tree that has literally grown here and it's probably 2 feet in diameter right in the doorway. So you know that the doorway was here before the tree was. We'll go inside here. Show you some of the other buildings are up on the hill too.
See, some of the timbers on this were not the cut timbered roof. Timbers on this were not the cut timbered roof like you'll see on the building up above it. This should have been the old church. The other buildings were probably built by the Anglos, circa 1880, early 1900s. The little room to the side, I'm not really sure what it was here for. It's possible it was a vertical. We have just staked a 20-acre claim on it. The area won't be able to be worked until it's excavated properly and proof of its origin.
Old boot, you want to pick it up maybe?
All these materials have washed down on top of this building. Civilizations are built one on top of the other. This stuff has came down at a later time. The very same two horseshoes that you'll see in the other picture of me with the forest rangers, May the 12th, 1988. They're still here. Nothing has been moved. Nothing has been touched. Someone has been here. But no excavation, as far as I know, has been done.
This is one of how many buildings?
Six buildings in total. This is the largest standing. The rest of them are mere hillocks of stone just barely sticking out from underneath the overburden.
From the top of a incline looking down. We came off from a hidden trail. This is a mission 9 miles from another mission that we stayed at called Nueve Mia Cuidad. 9 mile and coming up this way. Let's go up a little closer so we can get a better shot of this.
I can't get a close-up.
That's a tall short coast out of here. I don't see 300 of them, do you? It's awful still, though.
Pretty still.
Pretty still.
Remains of a deer. But here's an interesting artifact that we found sticking in the rock right here. all rusted over. Notched logs. And we have our claim.
This has been adobed in. You can see the layers in between half to 5/8 inch joints, where they laid these stones and just laid them in a symmetrically designed and laid the wall up. Not modern day by any term of the word.
We found this berm down here that's very large.
If you can, Dean, get a shot of this wall over here. This is beautiful masonry, and all with adobe.
Okay. That sure is.
All adobe and stone.
This wall appears to be about 2 feet thick.
It even looks like it was painted white on the inside.
Yeah, it looks like they used some kind of, this is not lichen. This is not lichen, it's like a whitewash. You can see in here. Lichen's a fungus type material that'll grow on these rocks, but this was like a pottery base. Let's see if I can scrape some off in my hand here. Give you an idea of not only the color but the texture.
It's almost a lime, ain't it?
It's almost like a limestone and marble mix, because it has some shiny material in it. On mortar joints to separate the stone or block, brick, or whatever in modern day joints, they use this ancient material. You can see how old this is. It's still blocked up to wedge the rock so they could get their mortar joints all uniform down through here. Quite interesting. Could very well be well over 100 years old. They use little stones like to brace up the rock. What a nice piece of masonry, isn't it? They put nails in for wedges anywhere they should. Probably laid this wall up in 3 sections. Up to here, maybe up to here, up to the top layer, just in this 10-foot section.
See the shininess on this rock right here. But the area is very mineral rich. Stories of gold, silver. Even the bells in this mission were supposedly made out of gold. You can just see everywhere. Foundation, walls. Here's our stake on the claim. Now we're going to go up the hill, and they're way over there with other ruins.
Indentation here, and see the stones pulled over. There's one there, there's another pad down here, and then the one where the claim marker is, and the church below it. You see the solid bedrock formation, the gold washing from above. And the reason they were probably here was to take the placer gold that had washed from the main vein, and with this solid bedrock, the crevices would have trapped it. Now there's further stuff on up the stream here.
And that's where we're going.
This is a placer formation, this mistake mine.
That tree's over.
One of my famous poems, I'd rather hug a tree than piss on ecology.
About 4 foot in diameter.
As far as I'm concerned, that is the iron door, that is the place to excavate, that is solid bedrock. There's water seeping out. There was tunnels here. This would be, after we archaeologically determine what's going on, this would be where we excavate.
See the barrel and wire? Come on up and get a little closer look at the wire. Beautiful up there. Barrel.
This is where all the wildlife comes. Before any work can be done in here, we'll have to put another water source because we'll interfere with the wildlife. I don't want to disturb anything or ruin anything. That water is seeping either from a cavern or a tunnel. Deer. Pig.
Water as clear as can be.
God, it feels so good. That is across from the spring. There is evidence of a dwelling that was on the other side. That was the fifth foundation in this once populous city site. The sixth one is up above us, high up on the ridge with no water.
Source right there.
Shooting downhill. There's the dwelling on the other side. And if you follow this down, there's another dwelling, and you end up with the mission at the base.
Five sites total. Done by burrows through, overburden. There's another stone house up on top before the mine. They brought the ore down here to the water. They couldn't mine without the water. Worked the placer down here and worked the veins up above. There's one story in 1932 where a man in an Oklahoma hospital offers to pay McKee $5 million to tell him the location of a spring. There is your spring. Over here is another building formation or foundation.
Well, she's out somewhere past Catalina, and her name is Esmeralda.